Hey, what's up, you guys? It's Acidglow here. So we got some more Injustice multiplayer with Bane, and I wanted to talk about some of these old games that we no longer see at tournaments or have a very small presence. Like, for example, CVS2 has been a really popular game back in the day, and I think they stopped doing tournaments back in Evo a long time ago. If it's still run at any tournament, I believe it's still just like a side tournament and we never get to see it on stream. Now, I think there was a recent tournament, I'm not sure which one it was. I'm not gonna say if it was ECT, I can't remember exactly. I think it was within the past 2 or 3 months. They were showing a lot of old tournament footage from CVS2, and it really got me thinking again that I really want this game to come back. And I'm pretty sure a lot of fans want this game to come back too, because I know it's like one of the old school games that people love to play in tournaments and at a very high competitive level, which goes the same for even the older Marvel vs. Capcom series games like Marvel Super Heroes vs. Street Fighter and X-Men vs. Street Fighter and possibly even X-Men Children of the Atom. And even on the Street Fighter game side, there's even games like Alpha 1, Alpha 2, and I heard Alpha 3 was very popular in the tournament scene in America, and also in Japan. So I'm looking at some of these old games, and I know in some tournaments they've tried to resurrect or get some more interest renewed into the game to possibly, you know, get more people to come back and say, listen, I want to join this tournament for this old game. And possibly just build more interest to kind of revive the game again in the tournament scene. But from what I see, because Marvel 3 and Street Fighter 4, Injustice and Mortal Kombat 9 have been like the top fighting games for a while. And I'm going to add Tekken on there. Even though I don't play Tekken, I do see quite a bit of Tekken streamed also in tournaments. So I'm looking at these games and I know these are very popular, and just looking back at some of these old games, I know there's a good percentage of people that still want some of these old classics to come back just so we can play them in tournament play once again, or at least, you know, play them against some more players. So, you know, when we look back at, say, the 90s, you know, when some of these fighting games that were out back then, they were really popular. The big one, I think, was Alpha 3. So when I look at Alpha 3 and how much has changed compared to the games we have now, you know, the competitive aspect and the size of the fighting game community has grown a lot bigger, especially since Street Fighter 4 got released in 2009. I think that just blew up everything, and that like renewed everyone's interest to get back into tournaments and play at a competitive level for the Street Fighter 4 games that were coming out. And you know, when they keep revising this game, you know, Street Fighter 4, they've got Vanilla, they've got Super, they got AE 2011, then AE 2012, and now we're gonna get AE 2013. And I'm hoping they add some extra game mechanic or some more characters, because if it's just another update with like just more changes to frame data, I don't think the game is going to continue to get a bigger scene. I think it's as big as it can get right now, where it's a bigger difference compared to the 90s. You know, because back in the 90s, people weren't traveling around the world as much for the tournament scene. It was more like a local kind of scene, like you'd have a big group of people within your city, or maybe a city or two down, you know, the East Coast or the Midwest or the West or Central or so on. But, you know, when I'm looking at some of these older games and how much some people really loved these older games, it would be nice to kind of have some more interest renewed in these older games so we at least get to see them again on a competitive level, or at least a highly competitive level. Because I never really got to see that much Alpha 3 tournament footage aside from the Valle versus Daigo match, I believe in 98 or 99 it was. I think it was in San Diego. I could be wrong, but I believe that's when it took place and where it took place. But if you guys know exactly the date and location, feel free to correct me. So, you know, like CVS2, I really, really want to get into that again. And It makes me wonder, like, what if they brought back, like, even more obscure games, like Clay Fighter, you know? Like, would people even want to play Clay Fighter on a competitive level at a tournament? Like, what if they actually legitimately said, you know, we're going to have a Clay Fighter 63 and a third tournament, you know, for like 64 guys or something. And first place takes like $500 or something, or $1,000, you know, whatever it would be. Do you guys really think top players would want to get into that? You know, aside from the money aspect, you know, would you really think they want to put up with a game like that, Clay Fighter 63 and a third? I played that on N64. There's not much I can say about it. It was okay here and there, but you know, what if they also bring back like, say, Rise of the Robots, some really bad game. Rise of the Robots was terrible, you know? You know, I really liked those mystery tournaments they did at one of the recent tournaments. I think it was UFGT9, I believe that was the one, where they had like a whole bunch of mystery game tournaments. There was Fighter's History, I think Fighter's History. There was Power Instinct or something. There was a bunch of other games, but it was all like really old school arcade games that not many of us would have heard of or even wanted to play back then. So I did like seeing that in that last tournament, like all these weird ass games there. And I think they had Avatar Fighter. Wow, that's on Xbox, but I don't like that one. But anyways, you know, I would like to see some of these older games come back. So what do you guys think?